Second, we look up problem. Now let's see, this is an interesting problem. Okay, till now, like, we have been focusing on a problem wherein the search is exact match. Now you should have asked me when I would take a non-exact match. Okay, so this non-exact match, being a teacher, like, I use this a lot. Okay, so this is the grading scale that we have in VCU. So the grading method is, if you are getting 90 and above, A, 80 and above, B, but less than 90, 70 and above, C, 60 and above, B, and less than 60 is you are getting F grade. Okay. So we have this as a, these are some course codes. So in US, like, they have this. Okay. So if you have ELEC 101, it's a first course in electrical department. Okay. Physics first course, CS computer science first course. But you, if you have like courses like 5 or 6, they are in the, like, typically 6 levels are master's level. Okay. 4 or 5 levels, maybe 5, maybe also master's. 7 is like, okay, master's or PhD. Right. So you have this, these are the course that they have. Okay. Now I am interested in knowing that what is the grade of this guy? 96 marks. Definitely this guy would have got a grade of A. This is the answer. How I can produce this using the VLOOKUP? Now, if I try searching VLOOKUP this value, and please note that I can do this using if else. Okay. How many if else you have to use? Just think. How many outputs are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So for 5 outputs, you have to use 4 if. Imagine 4 nested if you have to use. The formula can become very complex. Okay. You can achieve the same thing using VLOOKUP. But let's see if I do VLOOKUP. This is my lookup value. And this is my table array. Okay. And I'm searching in that. And column index num. What is the column index num? This is first and this is second. So I'll say 2. And I say range lookup. I say true. Assuming. Sorry, false. Because this is what we have learned today. Exact match. And it will say NA. There is no exact match. So 96 has no match here, right? So that is a problem. Okay. But if I give true, what will happen? See, it has given me 96, it has given me A. Okay. Now, why it has given me A and why not B? Is it because 96 is near 90? So when we are giving this true, so this, see, true is approximate match. So what it says, so you have to see approximate match. The values in the first column of table must be sorted in ascending order. Okay. So if it is sorted in ascending order, okay, so which is like what we have the case here, it is sorted in ascending order. Okay. Then it will go to the nearest value. Okay. Now, when we say nearest value, there is a caveat here. If I give 80, let's say 94. Okay. So then you can say the nearest value is 90. Definitely. What if I give 89? The nearest value is 90. This is what as mathematics say. So what we do is, I will search, I'll make this 89. And see that it has given me B. Shouldn't it have given me A? Because for 89, 90 is the nearest value. So the way this works is, nearest value less than. Always remember, it is less than the number. Okay. So even though for 89, 90 is the nearest value, but the way it works is less than 89. So which is the nearest value less than 89? It will go to 80 and it will give you this value rather than giving this value. Okay. So nearest is not like what we have learned till now. Okay. In Excel, this VLOOKUP, the nearest is slightly different. It is less than. Right? And now if I do this and I drag it, note that this has worked fine, but there is a problem here. Why the problem is there? See, the table range has changed, and that is what I explained that time. We have to fix this table range, otherwise for 65, 94, there is no problem. It is like within this range it is searching, but it will come NA here. So always remember, when you have this type of thing, you should fix both the starting and ending. Both you have to fix. And then you will get the answer. Right? So exact match.